In the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who govern all things, both in heaven and on earth, mercifully hear the pleading of your people and bestow your peace on our times. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Melchizedek, King of Salem and priest of God Most High, met Abraham as he returned from his defeat of the kings and blessed him. And Abraham apportioned to him a tenth of everything. His name first means righteous king, and he was also king of Salem, that is, king of peace. Without father, mother, or ancestry, without beginning of days or end of life. Thus made to resemble the Son of God, he remains a priest forever. It is even more obvious if another priest is raised up after the likeness of Melchizedek, who has become so. Not by law expressed in a commandment concerning physical descent, but by the power of a life that cannot be destroyed. For it is testified, "You are a priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek." The word of the Lord. You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek. The Lord said to my Lord, "Sit at my right hand till I make your enemies your footstool." You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek. The scepter of your power the Lord will stretch forth from Zion. Rule in the midst of your enemies. You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek. Yours is princely power in the day of your birth, in holy splendor. Before the day star, like the dew, I have begotten you. You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek. The Lord has sworn, and he will not repent. You are a priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek. You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Jesus preached the gospel of the kingdom and cured every disease among the people. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus entered the synagogue. There was a man there who had a withered hand. They watched Jesus closely to see if he would cure him on the Sabbath so that they might accuse him. He said to the man with the withered hand, "Come up here before us." Then he said to the Pharisees, "Is it lawful to do good on the Sabbath rather than to do evil, to save life rather than to destroy it?" But they remained silent, looking around at them with anger and grieved at their hardness of heart. Jesus said to the man, "Stretch out your hand." He stretched it out, and his hand was restored. The Pharisees went out and immediately took counsel with the Herodians against him to put him to death. The Gospel of the Lord. In today's Gospel from St. Mark, we heard in chapter 3, especially verse 2, there's a man with a deformed hand. Jesus cures him, and the man is healed. One author that I read in a reflection said, you know, it's good every once in a while throughout the year to prayerfully look at our hands. Look at them. And then reflect on how do we use them? How are we using these? We have two of them. Of course, we use them in prayer. We use them when we pray the Lord's Prayer. Our hands are extended. We extend a sign of peace. In just a few moments, we're going to come up. This is the only time we do this. Of the whole day, we're going to do this. With our hands, receive God. That is amazing. Now the author goes on and says, there are hands that do sinful, awful things. And the author, it's a long reflection. But one of the things the author reflects on, those hands that perform abortions. Look out. At the end of time, when judgment comes, God's going to focus his judgment, first of all, on those who commit abortions. God will say to them, "That's not what I gave you hands for." And in hell, they're going to suffer. There's a special place for hell for those who perform abortions. And their hands and arms are going to be grotesque. And their pain is going to be so intense that the pain they inflicted on the unborn in the mother's womb, there's pain there. The unborn feel an intense pain. Now their pain is going to be that kind of pain times a billion. No relief for all eternity. Oh, they're growing. They're going to be so depth in hell that why did my hands do this? Why? Those who perform abortions, doctors, nurses who assist, secretaries who fill out the forms, biological men who drive the biological women to abortions, they're culpable. And their hands are going to be horrible. Okay. Jesus' hands were nailed to the cross. Why? So that our hands are free to be the hands of Christ in the world today. You see, that's how Jesus did this. He says, "I want your hands to be mine in the world." In this National Eucharistic Revival,
It's a three-year revival. We're in the first year. Now is the time to ask God that our hands become Eucharist, that our hands become Eucharistic hands in the world today. Our hands are so beautiful. It's good to take a look at them every once in a while, maybe quarterly. Just sit quietly and just look at the beauty of our hands, because they are Eucharist. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And together we stand, coming together before our merciful Father this morning, let us offer him our prayers and petitions. We pray for the church. May God grant her fidelity in living as witnesses to Jesus Christ, the Most High Priest. Let us pray to the Lord. For the world leaders, may the Lord help them serve their people and lead with compassion and mercy. Let us pray to the Lord. For all who struggle with difficult family relationships, may Christ, the Prince of Peace, guide them in reconciliation. Let us pray to the Lord. For this faith community, may the Holy Spirit guide us. Let us pray to the Lord. We pray for all life from the moment of conception to natural death. Let us pray to the Lord. We want to pray for all priests, religious order priests, diocesan order priests, but especially for Father Mike, Father Taylor, Father Michael, who's visiting us, Father Ron, and Father Tom Bowens, continue his healing process. Let us pray to the Lord. And we pray for all those who have died, especially those who will die in tragic accidents. Let us pray to the Lord. And then just in the quietness of our hearts, own personal prayers and petitions for our Heavenly Father this morning. Let us pray to the Lord. And we pray our Mass intention this morning is listed for Joe Gaffney Brown. Let us pray to the Lord. Heavenly Father, please hear our prayers we offer this day in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and
the
good of all his holy church.
Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these sacred mysteries. For whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your living Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people. He stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim. Holy. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is a chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith, we
proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and George, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, O glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Now let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
Lord, let us pray. Pour on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness make those you have nourished by this one heavenly bread one in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Amen.